Okay, welcome again to another week of the online elementary statistics class. This week we're going to be talking about discrete probability, and we're also going to be talking about the binomial distribution. So I have a question right here. I'm standing in front of our friendly bear. I don't know if he looks so friendly, but our friendly bear at Lake Tahoe Community College. And a question I've kind of wondered is that if you look at the bears and we take some samples of different bears, how many bear cubs do they tend to have? Or in particular, what is the average of the number of cubs in a litter for a bear? That is definitely going to be a discrete distribution. Because a bear can't have a third of a bear. Because it's either going to have no cubs, or it's going to have one cub, or two cubs, or three cubs, or four cubs. So we could actually create a chart. We could do a sample of the number of bear cubs a bear has, and number the next one and all the different bear cubs, and we could look at a little distribution of number of bear cubs versus the probability that they're going to have that many bear cubs in their den. And then the question is, what is the average number of bear cubs that we might have? So, for example, we might come up with an average number of maybe 2.5 bear cubs. That doesn't mean they're having 2.5 bear cubs, it just means that the average is 2.5. So that's one thing we're going to do, and those are going to be called probability distribution tables, and the expected value of that probability distribution. Another thing you might be interested in, we're in Tahoe, and the question is, we know that sometimes people come and win in the casinos, sometimes people come and lose in the casinos. Why do the casinos always win? And that has a lot to do with the expected value also, and something called the law of large numbers, which says that if you play many times, and people in the casinos play many times, and there's lots of people playing, that in the long run, we will always see the amount of return very close to the expected amount, this expected value. And then thirdly, we're going to be talking about the binomial distribution. So thank you again for coming to one more week of elementary statistics. And I look forward to working with you all week. And please ask some questions if you have them. Thank you.